Hello, this is channel Easy Self-Host. In this video, we are going to run FileBrowser, one of my favorite self-hosted apps. FileBrowser can be used as a cloud drive service to manage your personal files. It can also be used as a web UI to manage files on your server or volumes of other apps. It supports multi-user and file sharing, so it can be used among family members or small organizations. Overall, it's a simple yet powerful tool to manage your files. Let's get started to run it using Docker Compose. This is the Docker Compose file we are going to use. You can find the GitHub link in the description below. Like the other Docker Compose we'll be using on this channel, it starts with declaring the Docker network for our proxy server. The proxy server will handle HTTPS for us. We are going to create two Docker volumes. The root is for storing directories managed by the file browser. The database volume is for file browser to store its app data. Then let's define the file browser service. The image is the official file browser image. Then is some common parameters like container name, restart policy, and exposed ports. We also need to bind the file browser service to the proxy network, since by default it won't connect to any external network. The volume section is very useful for file browser, since you can connect virtually anything to manage by the file browser. And we are going to explore this later. To get started, let's first map the configuration file in this directory to the container. You will save this JSON file later. Then let's bind the database volume to the database directory in the container. And lastly, let's bind the root volume to the SRV directory, which we are going to use as the file browser root directory. The configuration file for file browser is very simple. It defines the port number the server will listen on, and it defines the file path for the database. Remember that we mapped the database volume to this directory. The root file defines the root directory the file browser will manage. We've mapped our root volume to this directory. And then we need to set up the proxy server for the file browser. I'm using caddy, so I'll add this new caddy rule to map the new subdomain to the file browser service. You can watch my last video to see how the caddy server is set up. Now everything is ready, we can go to the command line and find the Docker Compose directory. And here we run the command docker compose app-d. Now the file browser service is up and running. We also need to bring up or restart the caddy service to let it update its proxy config. If your caddy server is not started, you can run docker compose app-d. But for mine, it's already running, so I'll run docker compose restart. Now we can go to the browser and go to the subdomain we defined. Please also make sure the DNS is pointed to your server before accessing it. Now we are in the file browser web app. The initial username and password are both admin. After logging in, you will see an empty directory here. You can start adding folders or adding files. But I think the first thing to do is to go to the setting and change the password for the admin user. It's under user management and you can edit the user here. Let's only edit the password for now. You can of course do anything with the admin user, but I think it's better that we create a normal user with less privilege to make the system more secure. We can take the auto creating user home directory in the setting to make the user have their own directories. Then let's go to the user management again and create a new user. Let's define its username and password. And then click Save to create a user. Now we can log in as the new user. We can start doing something meaningful here, like creating a document directory. And in the directory, we can drag and drop some files here. The file browser has support for many file formats, so we can view the file content within the file browser app. We can also share our files to other people even without logging in. And we can restrict the duration for this file sharing to be valid. And also secure the link with a password. Now to try if this link works, we can try to sign out our account. And then go to this link instead. Then we'll be directed to this file sharing webpage. And after we put in the password, we can see the file. Let's try to open the file in the browser. We can see the PDF we just shared. Then let's log in our account again and let's try something new. With the flexibility of Docker Compose and Linux file system, we can mount any directory or file system we want to the file browser. Here we mount the current Linux user's home directory to a path in file browser. And this path is actually inside the ESH user's scope. Then let's go to the command line and run docker compose up-d again to refresh the docker compose file. And back to the web page, we can refresh, and then we see our home directory. And inside this directory, we can see our files in the Linux file system. For example, our docker compose file actually lives in this directory, and we can navigate to that directory and open the file. As you can see, the file browser also has a file editor that you can edit the files here, which is very convenient if you just want to edit a few files on your server, and now you don't need to go to the command line. I also use FileBrowser to manage files for other self-hosted services, for example, the media files of my Jellyfin server. Jellyfin is a self-hosted service that can stream media to any of your devices. Here on its webpage, we can see the media files in it, but its web app doesn't have the capability to manage files. So instead, I use FileBrowser to manage my media files. I store Jellyfin media in a Docker volume, and I can mount it here to a directory under my user scope. And since this volume is an external volume, we need to declare in the volume section. Here I add a Jellyfin media volume, and then I'll provide its original volume name, and also tell Docker Compose is an external volume. With this setup, let's refresh our Docker Compose file again using the command docker compose up-d. Back to the file browser app, let's refresh the page again. And here we can see the media directory, which contains the media file that's already on the Jellyfin server. Let's add some new video files to this directory. And you can see there's also a nice progress indicator for file uploads. With all the files uploaded, we can head to the Jellyfin server. Now in the library, you can see my new edit videos, and we can play the video files inside the Jellyfin web app. I'll create a video about Jellyfin later. There are some other smaller features that I want to show you. If you are logging in using an admin account, you can see all the user directories. But the normal user can't see the root directory if you don't give them permission. In the setting, you can actually allow users to sign up by themselves. And then you can see the create account option in the login page. You can also configure customized branding for the file browser server. For example, I have this logo file in a branding directory. And then I can set up the customized branding in the setting by giving the directory of my assets. We can also customize the instance name and the theme. With all this set up, the next time you go to the login page, we'll see the new look of your file browser. That's all for this video. Please consider subscribing for content like this. You can find the configuration files in this video on GitHub and the link is in description below. Thank you for watching.